she might be an artist, and we're just trying to give her the paintbrush. You know, she might be an author, and we're just trying to give her the ability to put words and sentences together.
Good morning, ladies. Can you give him his new pencil, please? I was telling Grace, I'm like, oh, cool, the kids are being nice and calm this morning, didn't I? And then 2 seconds later, Aiden was picking on Sam. Sam was screaming. Aiden was hitting Sam with a football.
See, Grace is, she's funny. She's beautiful. She loves to play games. She loves to be around people. She's very social. She was probably close to 6 months old when we found out. We questioned a lot of her delay in her process of, you know, sitting up and even smiling. Actually, cerebral palsy never really came to mind when any of this was occurring, you know, until we took her to the doctor.
For the past two academic years, we've used the Microsoft Connect to build games and apps for kids with autism. This academic year, we decided to try things a little bit differently.
So we have a very special guest rock star here today. This is Grace Sennett.
Over the summer, we thought about, well, what if there was one particular child that we could work with? And if she could actively participate in the class, come and visit the class, if the students could meet this child, if they could ask her questions, then that would just be hugely beneficial. We're trying to come up with different modes of her to interface and be able to communicate.
Grace, when you're in class and you have a question for your teacher, are you able to ask that question? Yes. Okay, now how do you ask the question?
Hey Grace, with your chart with the letters, is it difficult for you to point at letters that are not small, or is that a good size? That's a good size?
Okay. Would you like to send email?
Email's kind of getting old, maybe text them.
That's so 1990.
Because I'm on my branch right now.
I'm sure all of us are like really motivated to do like a really good job on this project, and we all want to like help her as much as we can.
I think this class helps to open your eyes. Like, we're all very involved with, you know, with modern technology and like the advancements in computing, but it kind of opens your eyes to the fact that there are these subsets of the population that are excluded from it.
This is the draw-free app. For example, if she wants to indicate to people that she wants to go for a walk, she could just put people representing her family members and also some scenery. What makes this different from like other paint applications is that it's a lot less dependent on like controlled hand movements that are required for like moving a mouse or like drawing freehand.
Grace, what do you think of the button? Do you like the button?
Button,
no,
idea.
Yeah. I don't like it.
Maybe like would a different you? Button. Like if yeah. It was easier to press, yeah. I think that would be.
This project, it's socially relevant because we're helping Grace, but it's also really an interesting engineering problem, okay? So as an example, we're trying to do eye tracking, okay? But we're trying to do eye tracking on Grace while her head is moving around a little bit. So, you know, you can maintain eye contact with something, but if you're maintaining eye contact with, you know, a letter on a virtual keyboard, but your head is moving around, it's hard when the frame of reference changes.
We want to create a decision tree, a computer science tree that you can navigate, and every single category will have subcategories that reflect that above category.
Do you like it, Grace?
I like, yeah, it'd be great for studying.
Essentially, the difficult engineering problem is determining intent. Intent, you have to have dwell on something. You have to spend some time doing it. If you want to type the letter A, you reach out and you hit the letter A, okay? But if your hand is moving around and it's hard to hit the letter A, do you make the assumption that the person wants to hit the letter A? So the challenge for us now is to kind of provide a safe non-stressed environment for Grace to use these different software tools. So we wanted to move some of the games into her house.
So you found it, all right?
Yep.
Grace can essentially use these some of these projects kind of in her daily life and see what it'd be more like to actually have them. She'll actually be able to like, kind of learn it over time.
A group of 3 to 5 students would work on a project for 14 weeks, and then they move on. I mean, a lot of them are going to work at full-time positions at leading companies in the United States. We are actively trying to create products that will work for Grace and for kids like Grace. So one of the things we're working on, in fact, is to try to create some kind of nonprofit corporate structure so that these products that the students have created can live on past the students' time here at the University of Michigan.